What is going on, everybody? First video back since Christmas. I hope everybody had a Merry Christmas, Happy Holidays, all that jazz. Hope it was a good time. You got to see some loved ones, and if you didn't, maybe you got a Zoom call in, stuff like that. Hope it was merry indeed. But we're back doing videos, regular stuff again. Today we're going to be talking about Pokemon because I am just kind of in the mood for some Pokemon stuff. I really have been just craving it. Last year at this time I was covering Pokemon super heavily because, you know, the new games had just released, so I was talking about Pokemon all the time. And now this year I'm sitting here and, you know, we get an occasional raid den event, but there's not a whole lot to talk about in regards to Pokemon. But we are getting around the time that new Pokemon games should be getting announced. You know, we're really anticipating next year's game. What is it going to be? There's some speculation about Let's Go Johto. I personally am in the ballpark of believing that we are getting Diamond and Pearl remakes, which is awesome. So we're going to talk about all that today, and I'm just really excited to talk about this because these are some of my favorite Pokemon games. But if this is your first time here on the channel, make sure you are subscribed for more videos like this in the future, because we talk nerdy stuff all the time, whether it be Pokemon, Fortnite, video game stuff in general. That's what this channel is about. So if that's your jam, make sure you're subscribed for more videos like this in the future. But let's get into it. So Diamond and Pearl remakes. This has been a rumor forever, and it makes sense. It makes a lot of sense that we would be getting Diamond and Pearl remakes, because the last remakes that came out, aside from Let's Go Pikachu and Let's Go Eevee, which are not considered mainline games, were Omega Ruby and Alpha Sapphire. Those were a while back on the 3DS. Now we are done with the next generation of Pokemon, with Pokemon Sword and Shield on the Nintendo Switch. So the next logical step is another remake. So next in line would be fourth generation after third generation. So Diamond and Pearl remakes. And I'm very excited for this. I'm very excited to eventually see whatever becomes of Diamond and Pearl remakes, because Diamond and Pearl was my first Pokemon game. I had played Pokemon in the past. I borrowed, you know, friends, Game Boys, that kind of stuff, and I had played the older Pokemons, but I had never had my own Pokemon game until I had my first DS, and then I got Pokemon Diamond and Pearl when that released, and I played so much of Diamond and Pearl, and then I later went back and played the older Pokemon games. But I'm just really excited at this idea that we are getting Diamond and Pearl remakes, because it holds such a special place in my heart, being that it was my first Pokemon game. But before I get into all this stuff, I want to just say that none of this is confirmed. We know nothing right now, and all of this is just pure speculation. There is no real evidence supporting the idea that any of this means we are getting Diamond and Pearl remakes. Does it suggest that there is a possibility? Yes, it does suggest there's a possibility, but it doesn't mean any definite way that we are getting a Diamond and Pearl remake this year. So do not get your hopes up. This is just a fun speculation video. Leave a comment below. Let me know what your thoughts are, if we're getting this or not. But I've got a couple different things to talk about in regards to this that make me hopeful that we are getting a Diamond and Pearl remake, because it's fun to just speculate and have fun thinking about what is possible. So the first place that I've brought us to is NME. Pokemon Diamond and Pearl remakes might be coming next year. This is linked in the description below if you guys want to check it out. It says here that according to a French Twitter user, Kelios, a noted account when it comes to leaks and Nintendo information, having correctly announced the date of the July 20th Nintendo Mini Direct in 2020 ahead of time, this tweet translates, "You're going to have your remake next November, stop complaining, and you're going to say, oh my god, Pokemon is the best license," referring to Diamond and Pearl remakes. That's pretty cool. A follow-up tweet also confirmed the releases of the new Pokemon Snap, Pokemon Unite, MRPG and Detective Pikachu 2 in 2021, praising the license for having something available for everyone. Nintendo have been remaking the Pokemon games over the years, with the latest remakes being Omega Ruby and Alpha Sapphire for the Nintendo 3DS, like I mentioned. Fans have speculated that Diamond and Pearl remakes have been coming for a long time, with one Redditor having run the numbers and the amount of Pokemon available in the Switch title, Pokemon Sword and Shield. This is very true. Gen 4 has a very serious lack of Pokemon in Pokemon Sword and Shield. There is a very serious lack of Gen 4 Pokemon. The Gen 4 starters aren't there at all. So it leads you to wonder, why were those Pokemon excluded from the Sword and Shield Pokedex with the two DLCs being available? It's likely because the next game is going to be Diamond and Pearl remakes, and they don't want us to get oversaturated with these Pokemon. They want it to be like a fresh experience with these Pokemon going back in. So they just excluded a fair chunk of them. There are some, you know, Garchomp is in the Crown Tundra, but a lot were excluded from the DLCs, which it makes sense when you think about the next game possibly being a Diamond and Pearl remake. remake. On top of that, you know, we have the tweet that you're going to have your remake next November, and this guy has confirmed some leaks in the past, so there's definitely some credibility there. Again, this is all speculation still, but it does make you believe that there is a possibility that Diamond and Pearl remakes are on the horizon, which I am just very excited about. However, the tweet from Kelios and the, you know, the lack of 4th gen Pokemon in Pokemon Sword and Shield are not the biggest thing that lead me to believe that we're getting Diamond and Pearl remakes. I think everyone at this point is simply speculating that Diamond and Pearl remakes are the next logical step because, you know, they quit doing the third iteration of generation games. You know, we used to get Platinum, Emerald, Crystal, that kind of stuff. They stopped doing that with this one. We got DLC content, so we're not going to get, you know, a new Pokemon game. We aren't getting Pokemon Gun, you know. None of that's happening, but I think that the next logical step now, obviously, in most Pokemon players' minds is Diamond and Pearl remakes are next on the agenda, but there is this new announcement that Pokemon has come out with on their Twitter page that definitely leads to some speculation being that Diamond and Pearl remakes could be announced. So, the thing that Pokemon announced that I am referring to is on December 31st, the International Space Station will have a special stream and some Pokemon are planning to make an appearance. This is really interesting. They even go as far to say as you'll have to find out who. Now, this is a really interesting collaboration. You know, you get to see the first sunrise from the space station and it's Pokemon oriented, which is really cool in its own right. This is the biggest thing that I think people need to not get overhyped about. Joe Merrick, the person behind Cerebi, is very adamant about saying that they should not overhype this and just take this as what it is, as just a cool event. And I 100% agree. I 100% agree that this is just a cool event that we need to accept for what it is and not look too deep into it. However, it does lead to some speculation. There's no denying that there is some correlation because of the two box art Pokemon that are found within Diamond and Pearl. We got Dialga and we have Palkia. Both of these are space oriented. We've seen them in games before and a lot of art in space. So this makes some semblance of sense. Now, I'll read their descriptions for you because not everything about this definitely means that we're going to see them. So Palkia has the ability to warp space, though it is said to create alternate realities as well. Palkia can use the power of space to travel to either faraway places or other dimensions. The basic controls can become more stable with Palkia's own breath. Palkia lives in the spatial dimension, making its behavior nearly impossible to study. However, Palkia has been seen in violent conflicts with its counterpart Dialga. Referred to as Deity of the Sinnoh Mist, Palkia is the only known Pokemon that can learn spatial rend. So, that alone, you know, Palkia does involve space quite a bit. Palkia is very heavily involved with it. Now, it does have, you know, alternate realities and stuff of that nature, but there is some correlation to Palkia and space. Now, if we move on to Dialga here, Dialga can warp time either by speeding it up, slowing it down, or stopping it altogether. It can also travel through time to visit the past, present, and the future. It is said that time started moving when Dialga was born, and it will continue flowing as long as Dialga's heart still beats. As Dialga primarily resides in different dimensions, its behavior is hard to study, blah, blah, blah. You know, it's the same as, you know, hard to study because it is in a different dimension. Aside from that, you know, there is, you know, a bunch of theories about black holes and time travel throughout space because of all of the things that we are trying to understand about space. So there's definitely, it's a lot less clear the correlation between Dialga and space, but it is still there. So that leads me to believe, again, less so than Palkia, but it does lead me to believe that Dialga and Palkia could be the two Pokemon that decide to show up during this sunrise event. It's definitely a possibility. Does this mean that these are going to be the two Pokemon that show up? No. No, it doesn't mean that these two Pokemon could be the ones that show up. Deoxys is a very obvious one that could show up during this. So it's all up in the air. Again, 100% speculation here. But it does lead me to get very hype and just support the idea that Diamond and Pearl remakes could very well be on the way. With this stream, we're going to have to wait and see. We're going to have to wait and see which Pokemon actually show up. But, you know, with the rumors of the Diamond and Pearl remakes being on the way, it does lead people to think, yes, this is going to be, you know, Dialga and Palkia showing themselves in a slight hint toward the next generation of Pokemon games. But that is it for this video, guys. Again, do not overhype this. I cannot stress this enough because there is so much hype that can build over something to just have it not reach that height that you have set for it. and this stream could be a bust and it could just be something cool as long as we don't overhype it. So that is my advice to everyone, is just take this for what it is, a cool event. And if it does happen to be a, you know, a reveal or a teaser for the next games, you know, that's awesome. But if not, just enjoy it for what it is. But like I said earlier in the video, let me know in the comments below, what do you think? Are Diamond and Pearl remakes on the way or not? I'm very curious to what other people have to say. I personally am very excited for the idea that they're coming back, and I really hope they do. But that is it for this video. Hope you found it entertaining and helpful. If you did, be sure to leave a like and smash that subscribe button for more videos like this in the future. Share the video with your friends. Let's grow this community here on the channel. Speaking of community, we got a community Discord. People over there playing games like Pokemon, Animal Crossing, stuff like that. There's a Pokemon bot in there. You can play Pokemon in the Discord server. So pretty cool, fun place to be. So check that out. If that is something that interests you, I do stream over on Twitch as well. After I record a couple videos here, I'm actually planning on doing some Mario Kart live on stream, so that'll be pretty fun as well. So check that out if that is something that interests you. I do also have a TikTok. I do, you know, just random stuff. I do exclusive content over there. I do, you know, updates, like videos are coming out, stuff like that, Twitch clips. So check that out if that is something that interests you as well. And all my other social media should be on screen here at this point. So if you're interested in keeping up with me, this channel, the stream, anything like that, check me out there as well. Like I said, that's all I have for you guys today. Thank you so much for watching. I'll see you all in the next video. We'll be right back.